brain.
Yeah. What do you know about the brain?
It's functioning.
What does it do?
The function.
Central processing unit of the body. Yeah.
Mind functions from the brain.
Mind functions from the brain. Okay.
It captures the things which we see and hear.
Yeah, it captures what we see. How does it function? Here's what it does. It's a CPU. It captures the information. Functions through the nervous system. Okay. Here's what I'm going to... Hi. Freyaz.
Yes, hi.
Nice to meet you. Oh, so we have more people joining throughout, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Here's what I'm going to say to you. Our brain, imagine this. When we're born with about 100 billion neurons. Yeah.
When in the womb,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, your limbs come later on, yeah. But yes. Hi. I know, isn't it? Even I think so. Welcome. I love that it's growing, and I love a session that's interactive. So.
Problem for recording. No.
I think she's getting it. Are you okay? I think it's recording. I'd rather have a session where we're talking to one another than I'm lecturing you. Yeah. So we were talking about how the brain functions, and what I was saying is, when we're born with about 100 billion neurons. We'll take the neurons as though they're cars or trucks. So we're born with as many cars or trucks as we're ever going to have in our lifetime. Okay. These are the carriers of information. But what we're not born with are the roads on which the trucks travel. Clear so far? So the roads are called neuropathways, and the trucks or the cars we're calling neurons. Now, as we grow, that's why when a baby is born, baby can't see, baby can't speak, because the roads have not been developed.
Network is not
there, right? So we have to create that. We have to develop that. The more successfully we develop that, the more successfully we can carry the information that we are gathering. Now we also have to keep these trucks in shape, these cars in shape that carry all the data and run around from different sides. We have two hemispheres of our brain. Have you heard of that?
Yeah.
Left hemisphere, right hemisphere. We have something called the corpus callosum. So all these various roads that get created have to bridge one side of the brain to the other side of the brain. These various neurons have to communicate from one side of the brain to another side of the brain, right? One side of our brain controls our numbers and letters and words, and the other allows us to speak, write, create. So the two have to be in sync with one another. The truck can carry the information, but if there's no road to properly take the information from one side to the other side, we aren't able really to speak. We aren't really able to get our words out. Can I get a tissue, please? So we have to develop stronger pathways, and right from childhood, if we develop the right pathways, then we're able to deal with many, many, many situations more successfully in life. You all feel free to ask questions or jump in anytime. I'd rather make this interactive. That's why we're sitting like this. Yeah. Yes, that's one of its functions, right? Also, the right side is more of our creative side, more where we are artistic, and our left brain is more logical. Okay, so that's correct, but that's just one function.
Left hand, right hand.
No, it doesn't. That's no, it doesn't depend on. Thank you so much.
So why some people can write left hand, some people can write?
That's just your dominant side when you're writing, but it has nothing to do with the right side controls the left side controls the right side, whether or not you're a left-handed person or right-handed person. To the best of my knowledge, that's the way it works, regardless of whether you write with your right hand or left hand. Okay? So what research is now suggesting is, there is this particular part of our brain where once we develop a pattern, or once we develop a habit, you know, once you get chickenpox, you're supposed to not get it again. right? That's because in your nerves it gets recorded. Remember those Purana type ka records?
Yeah.
That used to get played on the yeah. They were scratched, they were etched. Like the songs were etched into them. Like that in our nerves, it is etched. Every time you have a particular reaction, say you get angry very frequently, say from a very young age certain things triggered something off, you've actually recorded that reaction. Yes, you've actually recorded those reactions into your nerves. Okay, by the same token, we can record good habits, we can record bad habits. When you drive from work to home, sometimes you're not even paying attention to the road, but you end up home. Yes or no? Somewhere that path is recorded, somewhere that has been created for you. Similar way, a good habit. What would be a good habit? What's an example of a good habit?
Being nice to human beings.
Define being nice to human beings. Define being nice. Yeah, smiling is great, but you know, it's great for the person who sees it also, it's great for the person who smiles also. We take in about 80% of our information through our eyes. That's why in meditation, in prayer, they ask you to close your eyes. So you shut off most of the stimulation that is coming into your brain. That is the reason you're requested in meditation to close your eyes. So when you smile, it triggers a sensory part in your brain also, and when I see your smile, it triggers that in my brain also, right?
Smile, you can give and keep it with you also.
Uh-huh. True.
Is it smile? You can give
others. Yeah, it's kind of like a yawn. When you yawn, someone else yawns. Have you noticed that?
Yes.
We have mirror neurons.
Yes.
We have mirror neurons. So when somebody smiles, whether or not, even if you notice this next time, because I pay attention to these things a little more than I used to before. When somebody smiles at me, even if I've had an argument with them, even if I'm not too happy with them, but they'll smile from across the room, naturally only I'll smile.
Nature.
Even if I'm upset, then I'll remember later on, oh, I'm upset with that person, I should not have smiled.
Did this experiment once. Or if you smile at 10 persons, at least 5-6 will
smile back.
Yeah. 2-3 will be blank, and 1 or 2 will say, hey,
yeah. They're confused.
Yeah.
They're confused. Yeah.
So there is as you said, right in mirror, 90% will.
Yeah.
Like baby. If you smile,
yes, absolutely.
First time they hesitate. The second time they agree to smile.
But if you're in a crowded place and you smile, they might be thinking you're smiling at somebody else.
Yeah.
Behind someone.
So they might be like, he doesn't know me, I don't know him, he's smiling at me. And then when they realize it, they might smile back. You know? What happened with ladies though? Hi! No problem, come join us.
So that is what it is, your face is the index of your body.
It does. Come.
Is it bad? Yes, it's bad.
Haan, lag raha hai mujhe.
Madam, pucho na.
You can run.
Okay.
You're late.
Okay.
So
you're Freyaz Shroff, right?
Yeah, we'll share tissues with you. I'm using a tissue because it's hot.
Oh, it's okay, I'll
get you a tissue.
Okay,
so we talked about mirror neurons. There are different types of neurons, right? So smile is definitely a good way to connect with somebody. What we're saying is about creating successful mindsets. Means we have to create successful roadways. Many of us in everyday lifestyle, we're coming across stress, pressure, whether it's work pressure, whether it's home.
Anxiety, whatever, all these emotions.
Yeah, but we have fed those. You know the story of the two wolves? Do you know the story of the two wolves? I'll tell you the story. There was a grandfather talking to his grandson and was saying that there are two wolves. And one that needed to be fed and the other. Do you know this story? Have you heard of this? There was a good wolf and a bad wolf. And the grandson could only keep one. only keep one of the wolves, and he couldn't decide which one to keep. And the grandfather essentially told the grandson, it's whichever one you can afford to feed. Right? Feed. Same way, we have a good mind and a bad mind. Right? We have anger, we have fear, we have love, we have compassion.
Absolutely.
It is what you choose to feed that will develop your stronger pathways. Now, the younger we get you, the younger we get the kids, the younger age at which we teach confidence, we teach leadership, we teach the ability to make the right choices, those become habits, unlike the habits that we have developed. So there are some key ways we can develop these sorts of habits, these sorts of patterns. One is this smiling or laughter. Laughter sends an electric impulse all through your brain. So that's one. The other is gratitude. Gratitude for everything, including your problems.
Yeah.
Right? If you had to be thankful for a problem right now,
well, it is a learning.
It can be both, right? It's a learning and a beginning. It's however you so choose to look at it. But I couldn't find the place today. I couldn't find this thing today. And I called the office to say I cannot find the place. But then I also had to give gratitude for not finding the place, because coming here, I found a particular store that I'd been looking for so long.
Okay.
Right? So in...
Hold on, you say it in your mind, thank you.
Yeah.
In your mind, you say it.
Yeah, I say it in my mind. Sometimes
okay.
I say it out loud, but I'm a crazy bhavi, so I'm allowed to do that also. I go for walks at Marine Drive. I look up and talk and walk. So,
Sometimes.
Every time would make it crazy, right? So it's however you so choose, whatever is comfortable with you.
Okay.
Whatever is comfortable with you. So there's laughing, there's smiling, there's saying thank you or being grateful for whatever your life condition is. The more you are thankful, the more the universe wants to give you situations to be thankful for. So create more situations to be thankful for. How you react to somebody plays a huge part in allowing you to create these successful neural pathways, or neuro pathways as we call them. We always have a choice. Would you agree that we always have a choice? Yeah? Okay, sometimes where I speak, people say, no, we don't always have choices. We always have a choice, right? If you're not in the job that you want to be right now, or if you did not get that promotion that you wanted to, that happened by your choices, not by any other outside influence. If you appoint your life circumstances outside of you, means you're giving away your control. You give away your control, that doesn't allow you to have that gratitude, that doesn't allow you to have that joy, that does not allow you to have and create those successful neural impulses that we want to create. Making sense? Agreeing, disagreeing?
Agree, ma'am.
Agree, right?
We are giving some money to him. Now you have to take that back.
It's also your choice to give or not.
Yeah.
Right? And it's also your choice how you choose to react should he choose not to give it back.
Yeah.
Right? Whether it becomes your choice to cut him out of your life, whether it becomes your choice to understand his situation and still maintain your friendship, and it becomes your choice how you will translate that event, or what meaning you will give that event in your head.
Fine.
Okay, so it's how you react to a particular situation as well. Foods, certain foods can help our brain. What sort of foods?
Ma'am, like, I don't know, I mean, something like...
Guess.
Boost brain power, like what? Kya ho sakta hai?
Kya ho sakta hai?
Walnuts?
Walnuts, yes.
Any food that is palatable?
No.
Badam?
Badam?
No, walnut.
Yeah, there's that email going around, right? Yeah, blueberries help.
What are the foods that promote serotonin levels? These are the chemicals of the brains, right?
Right. Red wine.
Oh, it's good for the brains.
Red wine is very good for
not
the brain. No. Red wine. No, see, I guess that's a neural pathway you've created for yourself, is it not? That certain things are good for ladies and not for gents. That's a neural pathway. So we got to work on that. Fish is good. It has omega 3 in it, which is good for your brain. Flax seeds are good for your brain. Red, right? That's why we're talking about red wine as well, because of what they have in it. Green, yeah, blueberries. Somebody already said blueberries, yeah. No, actually. Okay, I didn't know about amla. Yes, but also because they create lubricant. They have oils. Your neurons communicate through due to either chemical impulses or electrical impulses. So brain function is boosted by food that increases those chemical signals, electrical signals. Your fish is actually giving you that oil, that lubrication, right? A car needs lubrication. Neurons are your cars. So think of it that way. The other thing that allows us to create very, very successful roadways are sleep. Is sleep. Good amount of sleep. Like I will not trade my sleep for anything in the world. Meditation is good for the brain, but when we're talking about creating these, and I'm a huge proponent of meditation, but when we're talking about creating successful roadways, all meditation does is it calms you down enough for your information to travel in a more conducive manner. It does not necessarily create a new pathway. At least not from what I have learned or what I have studied. It sort of like when you sleep, all day long you've been collecting data. Like today you've met me, I've met you, you will have heard this information, you've gone to work.
Office at this, all these things basically.
Yeah. Everything has happened. Now all of a sudden when you sleep or when you meditate, what you're doing is you're putting all the files in order. It's like all the data has been taken, all the papers are there. This paper has been signed, that paper, and your desk is full. Now all of a sudden when you sleep, it's like something is going in and filing all those papers where they belong. So if you don't sleep long enough, then all those papers don't get to get filed the way they need to get filed.
And then you get stressed and anxiety basically. You get irritable basically.
You may get irritable, but what will happen is you might not be able to recall something you did the day before.
Okay.
You might not be able.
Basically.
Yeah, you might not be able to completely remember what you had in this, what conversation we had, what were your deliverables from the conversation. Because if your brain requires 8.5 hours to sleep and file away everything, and you sleep, say, only 4 hours, you're filing away about half your content.
So you'll be here, basically.
Yeah, and then you're right. What's the next thing it leads to? You're at your table at work and you're looking for that thing and you can't remember where that thing is and you can't remember what the delivery. Now you get frustrated. Now you've triggered off another part of your brain, another set of chemicals going off in your brain. And all of a sudden you're creating that pathway that becomes stronger and stronger. And what's that pathway? I don't like my job. I don't like my job. I don't like my job.
That rut basically you're getting into.
Right? And so you're just creating that thing. If I don't get this promotion, then I have failed. If I don't get this promotion, then I have failed. What you're perpetuating it by not taking care of your inherent health only. Whereas if you changed your perception around it, if you got the right amount of sleep, if you ate the right kind of food for your brain, all of a sudden things start changing. If you do your meditation, and I think meditation is a must, even if you're doing 5 minutes a day. Because it allows you to calm down, and actually even in the moment where you cannot find what you're looking for, if you just stand still for 2 minutes, you close your eyes and you just try to calm your mind, all of a sudden that filing cabinet opens up and you just are able to find that paper in your head as to where it is. So being able to come from it from a calm vantage point is very important. He's very calm right now. Look at him. Yeah, it does keep you in balance, right? And why does it keep you in balance? Because it's controlling your moods, it's controlling your reaction. It's allow, you know, when you're not balanced or when you're tilted, if you're tilted towards anger, that's the vantage point you're reacting from.
Then you have blue drink if you're tilted.
What
blue
is
yeah,
the, blue hai ya pani hai?
No, it's blue.
Blue hai but pani bhi hai na saath mein.
Is that because if you're tilted you have blue?
Flavored
one. Is it pani hai or it's a drink? Drinky hai?
Flavored.
It's good? I had apple.
Blueberry flavor?
Apple goa.
But really filter, I mean, change, this is, contains all the minerals, all G3, this and that. So this is, I mean, the brain cells, I'll let you know about it.
Okay, so we are just talking about successful mindsets today. I'm not even getting into too much of the biology, too much of the science. We're saying that there are trucks. We're saying that there are roads. We're saying that we're born with as many trucks as we're going to have. And we're saying that we need to create the roads on which those trucks need to go. Okay, we have to keep our trucks in good condition or in good shape. You have to first create the road with good quality material. Then you have to create and keep that road in good condition. So when if you don't maintain your cars, they keep dying off. When they die off, in your brain, you cannot go to a store and buy another car. It's done. It's finished. Then you have to function with the amount of cars you have left. And remember, you have neurons throughout your body, right? Because information gets carried all the way from your toes to the top of your head. If I'm tap your head. Can you feel it? Yeah, neuron signals, right? Going over here, which allow you to feel, allow you to sense. So you need those impulses to stay alive. Okay, we need to keep our roads in good shape because otherwise we get these khaddas, we get dead ends. And we need to create, when you get a dead end or when a road is under repair, do you ever notice that they give you a detour? Yeah, they actually label it detour, right? So we're doing something similar in there, where we are mapping the roads in our brain, where we're setting ourselves up for success. So we are lighting up parts of our brain that we don't normally light up, because every day, how much of the work that you're doing, you do in a conscious manner?
Hardly
anything. Everything is on, for most people, everything is on default. Waking up, eating breakfast, getting dressed, getting out of the house, going to work, what we do at work, who we talk to at work.
It's all mechanical basically. It's not like, I mean.
So your brain is not doing any work during the, if you are following routine after routine after routine after routine, those cars have, those cars and those roads, yeah, they have nothing, no work to do. So when they have no work to do, they can't stay sharp, they can't stay alert. Your job is to keep it sharp, your job is to keep it alert, not use the calculator to do math. Yes, sir.
In fact, birth, they are not conscious. Actually, they are supposed to be conscious.
You are supposed to move around spiritually, at least with a very, very conscious mindset. What it is you are doing, who it is you are interacting with, whose life you are affecting today, how you are changing your life today. You are supposed to walk around from here, from your center, which is in a very conscious manner. But most of us walk around a very default kind of manner. We're on autopilot. Whether it's the relationships. Now, I asked you all to say your names, trying to think in my head, how many names will I remember? How do I connect to these? You know, how do I individually connect to everybody over here? Standing up and lecturing becomes very easy. Because you don't have to interact with the person. You can almost be, in surgery, the doctors actually cover up the patient fully. Even they put the parda from here so you don't necessarily see the face. You're completely detached. You only are dealing with that part on which you are operating. That's how most of us roam around in our lives, in our daily lives, completely detached. How many people are you noticing on the street? Are you noticing what is required by those people? Are you only thinking about what it is you need? And are you even telling the truth to yourself about what it is you need? Well, we're not necessarily saying that we need to show concern at this particular moment. We're just saying we need to be observant of what is around us, right? But we should be concerned as well. So, yeah, that yes.
You have to be present, right?
Yes, you have to be present. That's correct. That's absolutely correct. And also what we're saying is that when you're present and you're walking around in a very, very present manner and you're in your life, and I said something about telling the truth to yourself, and you know, people always make these faces like, I'm not exactly sure what that means. And what that means is you, if your job is boring, then you have to own that for yourself. You have to say it's boring, but I'm in it because I need to earn the income, and that's the truth of the matter. Yeah, you Required. Okay, successful thought processes. So what have we covered so far? Who remembers?
Smiling.
Gratitude. What else?
Awareness.
Spinach. Yeah, that's laughter. That's what he said. Food. Certain foods, right? And we're grateful for?
Thanks.
Grateful for what, but? We're grateful for the good and the bad. Because everything is relative.
Nothing is bad, then your mind says it's a good
idea. Yeah, it's the meaning that you give something. It's the
you give the name.
Yeah, it's the meaning that you give something. Yeah. There's a lesson in everything if only we want to see it. If only we want to work with that. Right?
Positive mind you should take.
Yeah. I mean that would be really nice. Maybe that can be level 2.
How do you make I'm quite negative. How do you make a person positive, like, you know? I'm really negative, you know.
Uh-huh.
So I won't come positive, very positive, which I'm maybe like difficult, you know, but how do you do that? Supposing I ask you.
You go to the gym to lose weight?
A
person goes to the gym to lose weight. Does it happen overnight?
No, it doesn't.
Does it happen in one time he goes to the gym and he loses 10 kilos and he comes out? Right. But it's a few months of consistent effort.
Okay.
Right? He has to get up. He has to change his clothes. He has to go to the gym. He has to work out. He has to have a shower. No, it takes a little extra time, right? If now all of a sudden...
If you go for anything, you keep the timing for every day, then work will be easier.
Yes. So you're creating a time for it.
Yeah.
You're making a commitment to it.
Yeah.
So similarly, you make a commitment to this.
Okay.
First step in this is awareness.
Okay.
So every time you move towards that negative mindset, okay, the first thing is to be just recognize that that's what happened.
Okay, so negative emotion, a negative
reaction.
Okay?
And a negative reaction can also be a negative thought.
Okay.
So if something happens and you think negative about it,
okay,
that's the reaction you've had to that.
Okay.
So that's a negative reaction.
Okay.
First recognize it, then replace it. But if you try to replace it right from the start, it won't happen because you won't know what you're replacing.
Okay.
So for instance, let's say...
Rosie, I'm fat.
Okay. If you say that to yourself, first catch yourself saying that to yourself. Then replace it. Once you've got in the habit of catching yourself, because sometimes we say things to ourselves and not recognize in that particular moment how much negative chatter we have. So once you catch yourself in it, then replace it with something positive you know about yourself. I am intelligent, I am capable, I am confident. Yeah, but just you just said I'm fat. So then you replace that with I am confident.
So
right?
That's better, basically.
If you got angry with somebody and after the whole thing was over, you recognized, man, I should not have reacted like that. I would rather have reacted like this. So if you go, yes, apologizing to the person would be fantastic. But if you're not that type of person who is ready to go and apologize to that person, if you have a child at home, go home, hug the child.
Okay.
Go extend the opposite of what it is you have extended to the other person.
Okay.
Or extend the opposite of whatever it is you've extended to yourself.
Okay.
That's negative. Recognize it and extend the opposite of it.
Okay.
So step one is recognizing it. Step two is replacing it.
Okay.
Step three is making that your pattern.
Is it easy or is it tough?
It's as tough to develop a positive mindset for a negative person as it is for a 100 kilo person to become 54 kilos.
Okay.
It's equally tough.
But then you have to do
but
it.
But the dedication that person will need is the dedication you will need.
Same one.
Okay. But I tell you, sometimes the recognition phase takes a few months itself.
Okay. You realize you're a negative person.
No. Not. Don't stop calling yourself a negative person because you're not a negative person.
Can
we go? You just need to. You need
when
to.
You you're
yeah, you're affirming that to yourself.
So, I should not say that.
So first stop saying that. That's the first thing you need to stop.
Self-talk is required. Self-talk.
go and talk to your mirror.
Go talk to your
mirror.
Mirror. Mirror therapy.
Well, I'm not proposing any therapy. What I'm saying, let's not push him to do everything at one time, right? Let's do it in small steps. First, stop saying that you're a negative person. Okay?
With the comma.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Okay. Second step. Every time you find yourself even thinking that you're negative.
Okay.
Replace that with something good you believe about yourself.
Say I'm great or whatever it is.
No, I'm great is too vague.
I'm smart.
Yes.
Okay.
If that's what you believe. If you don't believe that about yourself, then don't say that.
Okay.
But you should hopefully get to a point where you do believe that about yourself. Okay. So recognize it, replace it. Okay. Then it slowly starts becoming a pattern, habit, good habit. How does it become a good habit? That same argument you had with the other that person where you couldn't apologize,
okay,
all of a sudden you'll be able to find your way to apologize to that person. So you're slowly conditioning your mind to move into that direction. Yeah? Don't speak badly to yourself.
Okay.
You have a spirit inside of you.
Jiva.
Right? Do you believe that?
Yeah, we all Hindus. I mean,
yeah. Okay.
I think Parsis are half Hindus only. If I'm not mistaken.
Well, I don't know about Parsis being half Hindus, but I know about me, and I believe that there's a spirit inside of us. Sorry.
We also have the yajna and all for worship and all, so it's similar. Of course, I mean, it's different, but you know, few things are thinking.
Hi, welcome.
I mean, generally, it's not here. I mean, yeah. I expect. You're saying something here.
No, what I'm saying is you know we are so hard on ourselves. We are hardest on ourselves than somebody else.
Yeah.
And I think if you recognize that you have within you a spirit that you have to also take care of, then you might be kinder to yourself. You might not call yourself dumb or
accept all human beings as
okay. So are you. That's what I'm trying to get at. I would love that if more people did that.
See,
nothing like it, right?
Jo main hu, jo main hu, hu.
No, 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 no. Jo main hu, so main hu, aur main badlunga nahi. Aisa to kabhi nahi hai.
You are taking it wrong. What I mean, see, accept yourself. The joke. Suppose you have strength, you have weakness. अभी weakness है. Strength को ठीक है वो बढ़ा सकते हैं. You can increase. Weakness, it is not easy to win. So accept, this is my weakness.
Joe, I mean, what can change, what cannot change? You accept, you should know the difference.
Unless you accept it,
you can't change.
Everything can change if you are ready to do the work to make a change. Everything can change.
The steps you're talking about.
Right, so those are three steps. That's homework for you,
okay.
I think. Three steps
okay.
that I'm giving you. First, recognize it.
Okay.
Second, replace it.
Okay.
After you recognize
okay.
it. So recognize, replace. Yes.
Okay.
And then make that your new pattern.
And how to do that?
Exactly this. Okay. I'll tell you how I started. One of
okay.
the things I did every time I have a negative thought, I snap my fingers three times.
Or pinch yourself.
I don't pinch myself. It hurts too much.
You can be lying.
But someone had told me walk around with a rubber band and snap it. That also hurts too much.
Yeah. So nice pinch. Small cute pinch.
Cute pinch then won't send a signal to the brain.
Oh, that would
be sweet. Hard night day, you remember.
Yes.
But
I wanted to be kind to myself.
Yeah,
so when I hurt myself, I'm working on negative reinforcement. I wanted to be kind to myself because I recognize that there's a spirit inside of me
okay.
that I wanted to honor as well.
Okay,
and that poor little spirit, since it's a child, whatever has developed, whatever patterns it's developed, it's not its fault. It happened. It didn't know any better. Now that we know better, we want to do better. So when I first started this negative thought thing, I still snap. You might see me on the road sometimes and I'll be snapping my fingers, and that's because something negative has crossed my mind.
And
yeah, but I don't care about those people.
That's
another thing. Yeah, that's why this crazy Bhabhi can look up and walk at Marine Drive also. Sorry? No, no, I don't stay at Khushrubang. But I don't have to own. Crazy people don't only stay at Khushrubang.
No, I think you're passing things. structure there. No, no, no. I didn't mean craziness. I thought it's a passing quality.
No, no. I don't stay at Krishnapad. What I'm saying to you essentially is that when I first snapped my fingers, I would not instantly know to replace it. But then I would recognize, oh, that negative thought is coming. That negative thought is appearing. So instantly I would try to find somewhere else to put it. Somewhere else to direct it. If I feel lazy in the morning, I don't want to get up. Instantly I'll reach for a phone call, reach for my phone to make a work related phone call. So that I realize that I don't want to give in to that pattern and just,
just stay in bed. That zone only basically.
So first you have to recognize it. If you don't know it's happening to you, then how are you going to...
So basically you become conscious. In other words.
You have to become conscious, of your actions and of your thoughts.
And that requires...
It does. Yeah. It genuinely does.
See, when you are aware, this is negative talk, then only you can cover. Convert.
Yes, yes.
But if you are not aware, if it is a your pattern, then you are into that.
Yes.
So,
are you understanding?
The recognition.
Yes.
Right. Madam, you said that when you regret saying something wrong.
Yes.
And you can't apologize.
Because you're choosing not to.
Opposite. So how to do it? For example.
Right. Where until your ego allows you to be big enough to go and apologize to that person, until you recognize that there's a whole spiritual element to it, which I'm not going to walk down that road at the present moment. But if you can't, for whatever reason, you choose not to go and apologize to that person, and you need to do the opposite of that, right? So if you've been angry at somebody or if you've hurt somebody, you need to find the opposite of that. So you need to be able to extend some love to somebody else, or you need to extend some compassion to somebody else. So you can give what you should have given him, or what you will learn to give him in time, you will give to another person. So you will extend your love to your wife, to your child, to your mother. You will go out of your way to do something for them you wouldn't have normally done in that day. So normally you would have eaten dinner with your mother.
They are doing it with someone else.
Yeah, that's okay. Yes, but you're reworking your brain. You're creating a new pathway for yourself.
If you visualize that person, apologize.
You can do that, but that's now walking down that spiritual pathway that we're trying. You can absolutely do that, but I want to rework your brain. I want to rework your pathway. I want your neurons to fire in new sequences. So if I want your neurons to fire in new sequences, if you cannot find the courage, or for whatever reason you are choosing not to go up to that person and say, listen boss, you know, I was just having a bad day, I'm so sorry, I shouldn't have yelled like this. If you don't want to say that to them, then you extend that love, that compassion to somebody else. Your neurons still get to fire in some modified sequence relating to the opposite action of that yelling. Am I making sense what I'm saying? Right? You hurt somebody, you should, ideally, you should want to work yourself to the level to create a pathway where you're able to own the fact that you contributed to hurting somebody's feelings. Even if you feel that that person deserved it, or that person did whatever he did, he brought it upon himself. Somewhere it takes two people to hurt one another.
Two to fight. It takes two to fight.
Yeah, it takes two. It's never just one. Never. So you had a part in it, he had a part in it. You have to first recognize that two of you contributed to the hurt. Two of you contributed to the distance in the relationship. First, you recognize that. Second, if there is sometimes in relationships, there's no apology to be made. Sometimes it just happens. Distance just happens. In that case, you just need to extend grace. You want to go to lunch? Let's go grab a bite. You see him somewhere in some public setting. You smile. You nod. You extend the grace. Sometimes an apology is not required. Yeah, so we're all working towards extending grace at the end of the day. So what are your three steps?
First,
recognize.
Recognize, replace.
Yes.
And then pattern.
Yes.
The pattern.
Yes.
And how to do the last step, first step?
How do you exactly? Yeah. So you'll recognize it. You'll start recognizing it 100 times.
Okay. Then replace.
You'll replace it say 10 times.
Okay.
When you start replacing it 100 times.
Okay.
Then when you start making it your new pattern, before you react, you will choose the new thing that you would normally replace it with.
Okay, the last part, I mean,
That's exactly how you will make it a new pattern.
Okay.
So, you get angry easily, right? This person hasn't done this, you get angry. This person hasn't done this, you get angry. This person hasn't done this, you get angry. So, you've recognized.
Okay.
Now, you get angry, you go home, you hug your daughter. You get angry, you go home, you hug your wife. You get angry, you get angry, all of a sudden you go and you apologize to that person. Right? So now you've replaced. Now all of a sudden, as you sense your anger coming, you're not going to react. You're going to find that other replaced action for that person. And it's not just Jadu Ki Jappi. You can play with your child. It's not necessarily you have to hug your child. But yes, I have a huge belief in the power of hugs as well. So that's a whole...
So Munna Bhai, you're a fan of Munna Bhai,
yeah? I'm a fan of that concept in that movie, yes. No, man, I'm not a psychotherapist. I'm not a psychologist. I'm not a psychotherapist. I'm just somebody who's lived life, who's had a few knocks, who's learned from those knocks, and who has stood up and is today living life as successfully as she knows how to. I'm not anything other than I have just said to you. Yes, I have absolutely, I've learned through having to work from a very young age, to being knocked in relationships, to having to deal with certain family situations, learn through difficult friendships. And I have just chosen in the long run to live in a much more positive way. And today then I share what I have learned and how it has helped me. And actually now, as of a month ago, I've opened something called the Kurnev Life Center, where I named the center after my parents.
What is it?
Kurnev. Yeah, my dad's name is Kurush and my mother's name is Nivi.
Okay.
So I combined the two and it's called the Kurnev Life Center. It's at opposite Metro. And we work with children starting at the age of 5 to start creating these successful roadways.
Wow.
To build their confidence, lower their levels of fear so that they can understand what choices they have available to them, how to make the right productive choices and start creating leaders. Work with children from the ages of 5 to 17. We work with parents, we work with couples, and we also have a program called You and Your In-Law. Only because in India we have so many joint families. So it's all about being able to connect your body, mind and spirit. And we have some amazing partners with us. In fact, I train with our life partner, who connects. She's a personal trainer, but she trains your body and your spirit at the same time. So she starts with a 10-minute meditation. While you're working out, she'll tell you to look up at the universe, take this from the universe. So she's connecting your spirit to your body, spirit to your body. Then we have another coach who connects your mind to your spirit. Bring her along? Yeah, I'll do that. So I'm the person out of our life partners who connects the mind to the spirit. So body, mind, spirit is kind of how we work it over there. So there is a spiritual component, there's a physical component, there's a mind component.
All have to combine. What is difference between spirit and soul?
I think they're the same. I think they're the same. I don't know of any, in my definition, of any difference. Bye, see you. I don't know of any difference. Yeah?
Many different words.
Yeah, different words. Any other questions? But essentially prayer will help you, meditation will help you, gratitude will help you, laughter will help you. There's something called touch therapy, like hugs. That will help you.
Playing with dogs, playing with pets.
Playing with pets definitely helps, right?
Huh? What did you say? Playing with pets.
But that's also touch therapy, right? Yeah. Also, holding somebody's hand seems to have a significant amount of result. Putting your hand on somebody's shoulder. Sorry? Yeah. But, you know, essentially we are all healers. in whichever way.
What you say is right, even imagine like this, yeah. That is the meaning. No meaning, you know, yeah. Somebody is passed away.
Yeah.
There is a habit, I've seen in our relatives and our community also.
Yeah.
They will just go on and the person will repeat what has happened again. For so many times. No need. See, that person, the loss is great.
Yes.
I mean, you are unnecessarily coming in
yes.
This
between
the again,
yes.
Ignite in them.
Yes.
So go and just touch it.
Yes.
Message is passed.
Yes.
That's all.
Yes. Agree.
No need to talk also.
Yeah.
In the same way, like you said, you are coming.
Yeah, message.
Absolutely.
You are touching your conventional.
Yeah. So, and it's important that because the other person is also getting that message,
yeah.
Right? Some people who are uncomfortable with touch, you have to also be careful of those people. Some people are uncomfortable with touch. Yeah, so you have to respect and meet the other person at the level at which they are, not necessarily at the level at which you are, but slowly, 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 there's a need for touch. So slowly those people will come around.
You know, through your body language,
the eyes language.
Yeah, absolutely.
Pet
therapy. Yeah, there's a whole segment on that. But essentially, this is all the core information I have for you about the trucks and about the pathways and about the roads. You can come closer.
How do you actually make the brain strong? Like, supposing, we all go through trauma in life. You know,
yes.
It's birth, middle of. So how do you make the brain stronger? It can take it without like falling down or that sort of
thing. Your regular patterns also have to be strong, na? And it also depends on what you define as trauma.
They're very strong. Some people go, they fall, they get...
It's the meaning that you assign to it also.
Okay.
It is the meaning that... To any event, it's the meaning that you assign to it. You will have people who get into a car accident
and they
end up handling it much better than maybe somebody else who gets into a similar type of accident.
What's the difference between them, I mean, whatever.
The meaning that they give to it. Some people think it's the end of their lives.
Huh.
And some people,
so, okay, I'm
some people, some whatever. People think, oh, you know what, it happened to prevent me from going through something else. I'm okay. I'm going to be okay. I'm going to be fine.
So they're
fine. It's the meaning that you assign to an event.
How you look at it is the way. Like two people.
Suffering is one. Suffering will come in the world, in this material world. You can't escape suffering, can you? But the thing is, yeah, suffering.
It's also how you define suffering. That's what I'm talking about.
Physical suffering, mental suffering, whatever.
Yeah. So, but suffering to you would be, definition of suffering to you would be different than definition of suffering for me, then would be definition of suffering for him.
One simple example, you are going by a car with your friend.
Okay.
And on the side of the road, one gentleman. Observe that.
Okay.
You may say दारू पी के पड़ा. Your friend may say accident हो गया चलो लेट अस. So same event but triggered different.
Okay.
So you how you look at it?
Yeah.
How you event is same and this requires a training.
No.
That is why what you do is accept and replace. This requires training. It is not easy.
But sometimes we can notice like whether वो दारू पी के पड़ा है कि accident हुआ है.
नहीं मेरा कहने
का मतलब है
एक ही event है but different trigger and that is our neuron.
Okay.
From the childhood because of our culture because of our education.
You know the chemical messages.
Your mind is trained in that.
What did
you
say?
Chemical messages, am I right?
They talk, they transfer
the
messages through chemicals, through chemical signals, electrical signals.
Okay.
There are different types of signals through which the neurons also communicate.
And that has a brain function wrong. Let's see what is it, right?
Yeah, neurons?
Not neurons, the chemicals being transferred.
Without the chemicals, they won't be able to communicate. Without the chemical signals, okay. Without the electrical
the
signals, how will they function?
Yes.
It's like the petrol in your car.
Okay.
If you don't put petrol or diesel in your
it
car,
work, yeah.
It can't work.
Okay.
So without these signals,
what is it?
They're like your trucks.
Trucks, they carry
the information.
Okay, to the brain.
Yeah, no, they're in your brain. They're throughout your body.
Okay.
They are
inside your body.
They are trucks. Like how you have वहाँ पे देखो. वो गाड़ी खड़ी है रास्ता दिख रहा है ओके दैट रास्ता इज द न्यूरो पाथवे दैट गाड़ी इज द न्यूरॉन ओके द गाड़ी कैन ओनली ट्रैवल ऑन द रोड
ओके
नहीं समझ में आ रहा
है
करे ओके
सी See,
I got it.
One neuron connected with another neuron. The same neuron is connected with number.
Yes.
That too.
And they have
the communication
these.
Communication is through synapses.
Do we have a, one second, here.
Now that figure you can show.
Yeah. I'm not an artist.
No,
huh?
No, okay.
See, they have these like what they call dendrites, axons, whatever you want to call it.
This, all over.
Yeah, your neuron. Your neuron, your one little neuron. Then this other one also has it.
Okay.
This one, for whatever reason, this connects to that one. Okay. Now you have a signal from here communicating with here. And now you have a road. This is what I'm calling the road.
Okay, fine.
So this is what I'm calling the truck. This is what I'm calling the road. Now this part of this neuron might connect to another part of another neuron. Now all of a sudden this is connected to this, is connected to this. Understood?
Absolutely.
So now let's put this in context. This is the event that happens, a life event. Okay, you're 2 years old, someone throws you into the pool.
Okay.
All of a sudden you're gasping for air, you can't breathe, you can't breathe. Okay, so this event happens, you have a reaction. Whatever your reaction is, you get scared of water, you feel that you won't, whatever. Now all of a sudden, this, you're 16 years old. Again, it's a life event. Okay, you're going to, you're at the beach with your friends. All of them want to go in to the water. All of a sudden, this, because it's connected to this reaction of fear, it triggers off over here. And now you're like, I'm not going in the water because this pathway of fear has already been created about the water.
Right.
So you don't go in. What you've done is you've made this connection stronger.
Okay.
All of a sudden, now you come to this life event.
Okay.
You have a daughter who's 2 years old.
Okay.
And your wife is telling you, let's put her for swimming. You've strengthened this. All fear. Now you won't send your daughter for swimming.
No, that would be it.
Now your wife doesn't know about this. And this and this, and your wife has always been swimming and is a huge fan of the water.
Okay.
You're unable to articulate that you have this pathway. You know what happens? Life event, fight with your wife. Now this is connecting to this. Are you understanding how your pathways are working?
Yeah.
All you need is one opportunity to make a decision to take this road. If you had gone into the water at the beach, now all of a sudden, life event, 2 year old daughter, no fight with wife.
Happy marriage.
All you need is at some point to decide you're changing the road.
Is it, I mean, easy or tough?
No, it's tough.
Yes,
it's
tough.
It's very tough. How you take it? How
okay.
You take it? That moment. Point. If you think it's a tough, then it is a tough.
But sorry, I'm over my time. So if you all need to go, that's absolutely fine. We're just, yeah.
What do you do as such?
Sorry.
What do you do as such? I mean, working wise.
What do I do as such? Like my personal career thing. I actually am a corporate coach, and I do strategy consulting with businesses.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
Which company are you with?
No, I have my own business.
Okay, yes.
So I have different clients.
Freelancer.
I have different clients, and now I've opened this life center where I work with individuals.
That's good. Fantastic.
Yeah. So that way. But making sense now?
Absolutely.
So now when you say, when you keep calling yourself a particular type of person,
negative
you've
person.
Taken this. Stop saying that. That's why I said a particular type of person. See, now catch yourself. Keep recognizing that. Right? Here's what's happening. Every time you're recognizing yourself, recognizing that, you're sending some reaction that you might consider this road or might consider this road. Now you come here, again you recognize it, you're sending a reaction, I might consider this, I might consider this. Finally, one day, you will actually take the other road.
Oh, fantastic. That'll be the chilling part, chilling time, right?
Yeah.
And that is why she said replace it, otherwise you will make that road bigger.
Yeah.
And then you know,
and then what will happen? This 2 year old daughter, guess what will happen to her? She'll pick up on your fear. Now, 2 year old daughter's neuron.
Yeah.
dad's fear. She never even got dropped in the water. She never even experienced the water, and she's afraid of the water. 16-year-old daughter, again, same cycle.
And parents also impart those network to into her.
Yeah, right? That's what I'm saying.
All the details. So another neuron will be network in her.
Are you understanding now? Now, let's talk about how, if this fight happens with your wife, life event fight with your wife, God forbid, let's throw that out, but seriously, if you have this, you can choose one of two things. He's so excited about this now. You can choose one of two things. You can either choose to perpetuate the fight. Like, no, the water is really bad. If she drowns, then this, then that, da 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 da. Perpetuate the fight. Or you can choose the other path, this other whatever road, I'm running out of board, like other road over here, which is like, Jan, you know that I have a fear of water. I don't know how to overcome this fear of water. I don't want to pass it on to our child. I'm not so sure. I want to do something about my own fear, but I don't want to pass it on to my child. How can we do that? Now, all of a sudden, you've developed a path of collaboration. You know what collaboration means? No fight.
It's the best piece of bread.
That is why in management they say you can't change other person's mind. The only thing you can change is perception.
Okay.
But you cannot change other person.
You will never change her pathway. Ever.
She'll be.
You can try from here till kingdom come.
But they were never.
Until she wants to. Yeah.
Okay. And that's difficult. I mean, that's
her choice. That is her choice.
Her choice.
Connections, there's a connection into there. That is why sometimes automatically the trigger, you don't know that fear, but fear that is triggered because of past life.
It's all past life.
No, no, he's talking about earlier in your life. Yeah.
Talk about the small bit, yeah, big dark, yeah, don't go inside, it will be...
Right, that, even for children also, right, we continually say, don't put your fears upon the child. Don't put your... Yes, it's your job to protect the child.